Through the personal stories and experiences of several master Japanese chefs in California and a teacher at the California Sushi Institute, learn how sushi has paved its way from a traditional delicacy in Japan onto food trucks and mass catering companies in America. Join us as we trace the evolution of sushi as we know it today.
I'm Phil Gray. Welcome to Subculture Club.
Starting in the birthplace of sushi in America, we visited one of the founding fathers of sushi in Los Angeles, owner and sushi man Nobi Kusuhara, at his restaurant Sushi Sasabune.
Just eat like that. No, you don't need soy sauce or anything.
My name is Nobi Kusuhara. I'm the owner chef in Sasabune.
In 1979, I opened up my first restaurant. And at that time, sushi wasn't that much, you know, around in the Los Angeles. Maybe 20 restaurants at most. And little by little, you know, the sushi bar is coming over. So we create a lot of different sushi style compared to Japan because of if I bring a Japanese style sushi here, the American people is so scared about the chewing like a clam and the sea urchin, all those stuff. So we create a lot of new dishes. We start dynamite. The people call dynamite. It wasn't dynamite. We didn't put the name on it, but then we started that one and mix up a scallop with a little using a marinade sauce. So easier to American people to introduce the sushi. That was just starting from 1979. Then about 15 years later, and the whole United States copied our menu. So then at that time, Nozawa was starting his restaurant also. So we said, maybe we should go back to old style. You know, so we went back to the traditional. So we just say, hey, we don't want to take an order. Why don't we give you the good fish? That's how we started like a Trust Me Special. So little by little, sushi bar start changing again. Some of the sushi men, they go to the sushi school and starting learning about sushi. But traditionally, if you want to make traditional sushi, it cannot be learned by school.
To learn more about sushi schools, we met with Annie Matsuda, the director of the Sushi Chef Institute in Los Angeles. He shows us how his knowledge and his passion for the traditional Japanese cuisine led him to support the rapidly growing demand for professionally trained sushi chefs in America.
My name is Annie Matsuda. I'm an CEO of Sushi Chef Institute. I'm not choosing the nationality, the ages, and race. Because I need to wide open. Because the situation you can see, we needed Japan, we needed training a chef and spending 5 years. And here you can see five restaurants in a month open somewhere. Only not in the United States, in the whole world, it can maybe 10 restaurants every month open it. And those people need a sushi chef.
Papers by right hands. Everybody? And pass on the right person.
It's all fundamental. Because if they don't have, person that has the fundamental skills, how can I create the dishes where people are impressed? I'm foundation. A Japanese person teaching Japanese fundamental skills it is. That's the block we're making a foundation for them. So they can build with the houses and top the foundation with creativity of fusion, dishes, that's fine, because everything in the fundamentals are same. So the sushi industry have been changing to the last 400 years, but last 50 years, we are changing the big time from here to every 10 years. Japanese culture is they don't want to change so much, so everything is slow. But here is all nationality changing. I want something new.
Always new.
So new. So this is all changing so quickly than, 400 years to last 20 years. That's it. So we don't know where we're going, but foundations are same.
We traveled to Sushi Roku, a gourmet modern sushi restaurant, where we met up with Chef Jiro Kobayashi to learn how Sushi Roku is pushing the boundaries of traditional Japanese sushi to satisfy the American palate.
When I was 18, wanted to be a sushi chef. It was difficult at first because they didn't really accept me because I was American. And then I asked them, you know, how is it for me to be able to be a sushi chef? And they would say, oh, well, the best way to do it is to go to Japan and get the real deal training. So I was like, okay. So I really wanted to be a sushi chef. And so I flew out to Japan. And for 4 years, I stuck it out. Went through my basic skills there and came back here and worked at a few other restaurants, and then for the most part been here ever since for 14 years. Sushi is always developing. There's always something new, you know, and as a chef, as in any type of chef, there's no ending point. It's always, you know, something new to learn. That's why I'm a chef, because I enjoy learning something new, and I'm always open to work with my coworkers and hearing what, you know, they know and seeing what they know, and that's how, you know, something special happens, is when you work with your team and bring new ideas together.
The first sushi in Japan was sold from a cart. Returning to these roots, TK, chef and owner of the Fish Lip Sushi Truck, hopes to bring sushi to the masses through the popular American craze of mobile food trucks.
This is a rice sheet machine.
Oh, so you don't have to hand roll it, it saves some time.
Right, usually people put it like, you know, like using the rice and put on that. Uh-huh. But the reason why I use it, that everything I want to make equal size.
Yeah, because so that way the portions are the same.
Right. And especially for the delivery, and it has to be like the same size, and the container size is the same.
So it has to be uniform.
Right.
When did you start the sushi truck? You started that a
long time ago? It's 3 years ago. Just want to see the something different and who never done before. And the truck business is that time, there's only a couple trucks in front of me, and they started, but at that time I didn't know that. And it was just simply maybe the using the truck and selling sushi is kind of like kind of interesting to, you know, do that, because the sushi history starting from you know, like a cart, and not like a fancy restaurant. That's like a newer style, so maybe they could just get back to the, you know, original for sushi selling. That's my concept, you know, what a friend, they said it is a good idea, but from a customer side, I feel like, you know, people like so skeptical. The sushi from truck, oh man, I don't need it. That's those kind of like a reaction what I get. I knew it's gonna be, probably it's gonna be happen like that. So I made a truck from scratch. So I bought an empty van and they're making everything brand new and the big window, and show the customer what we doing inside. But still, most of people, first time, they are skeptical. My target is not a Japanese people, not a traditional things, because I using the truck, that's gonna be different story too. So that's why my menu-wise, menu is gonna be more like American style, like using uramaki, or, you know, you can see like a California roll is not a traditional sushi. My customer is ever in United States. So that's why I more like try to match the people who can eat my sushi and more easily. If I put it everything traditional, it's gonna be, I'm not gonna be run 3 years for the, you know, this truck. You know?
We asked all the chefs we met with to tell us one last thing. What defines American sushi?
The American style sushi, it's maybe you can say so-called California roll. That's probably most popular style.
50 years ago, they started to local ingredients, to an avocado. And they use for crab meat, avocados, and cucumbers, and something made by me here. They're getting popular, it's a California roll is made. You can see the experiment of a traditional doesn't come popular, but something can create the new things in California roll, spicy tuna, rainbow roll, crunchy tempura rolls. Then American people loves it. Then why not?
American sushi is a lot of rolls, I think, is really popular in American style sushi. They like to dress things more in American sushi. I think in Japan, it's very simple. You know, they just stick with simple ingredients, soy sauce and wasabi, and fresh raw fish.
Definition of sushi in America is getting kind of split in two ways. Like us, more traditional style, keeping the fish quality, and some other restaurants, they're going for the price lower, but however, they are like a gourmet food. They're making a lot sauces and they're using like a tempura roll or, you know, spicy tuna roll, and they're going for that way. It's not, I don't say it's bad, it's good way to having a Japanese food is developing that way too.